Hi. Do you remember if the glove does not fit, you must acquit? That was like 15 years ago. No, 25 years ago. Well, the gloves fit, so you can take me away in handcuffs. I murdered O.J. Simpson. No, wait a minute. He murdered somebody else, they say. Anyhow, these gloves will be with me in my trip next month. I bought some long underwear just in case there's no California weather out there and I can't go around like this. I have to have underwear up to here and all the down legs to the ankles. And I've got wool socks and I've got a nice pair of boots I've had for about 2 years now. I think I bought them before we went to Yosemite, but we didn't go to Yosemite. So all I've done is wear them walking now. They're not expensive boots. Nah. They only cost me about $60. But that's enough to make sure they're strong and they're good and I can walk in them. So I'm about ready to go. Meanwhile, another big daydream. I went to the post office today and for $6.70, I mailed the package with my manuscript to Boston for the Amy Lowell Prize. The deadline is Monday the 15th, and it must be in their hands by Monday the 15th. That's a week from yesterday. It's also Maria Teresa's birthday. So, you know what a special day that is. I'd like to just get up and walk over to the refrigerator and pour myself a glass of wine. I just came back a few minutes ago from the post office. I'm mailing this package. May it be lucky. Last year, fewer than 300 people applied for this prize. $59,000. Now, to some people, that's just what they would pay their cook for the year. And not a very good cook at that. Not one of those famous stars. No, they get hundreds of thousands of dollars. But $59,000, or maybe it's only $50,000. Probably after taxes, that's all I'd have left if I were lucky. Because I do have to pay taxes on it. It's not a gift. It's a contest prize. Last year, fewer than 300 people applied for this prize. And this is the first prize I've applied for that I think I had such good odds. Most other things I apply for, there's more people, hundreds and hundreds more. But this one I've been thinking about for, oh, good grief, 3 years now I've been thinking about it. 2 years ago I said, oh, I'll have to apply next year if Mom's not alive. And next year, last year, she was still alive, so much as I wanted to, I didn't apply. See, the thing is, if you win, you have to leave the continent. And that means if I win, I have to leave the continent, little camera, with you in my pocket, to leave the continent for a year. Look down at the camera, Daniel. It's down there. Follow your finger. There you are. Just look at your finger. There it goes. There's the camera right there. I'm looking at it. But I don't want to. I'd rather look at myself. I'm so pretty. Ugly hair, crabgrass on my chin and my neck, long hair sticking out. Oh, Daniel, you ain't pretty. You an old man who sent some of your poems to the prize judges. Yeah. I should read you one, but Psychobabble might not like it. Not that that ever stopped me. So, here I am, sitting in the doorway of the kitchen. A month before I go back east for a couple weeks on the train, a lot more work to be done here before I go back east. Maybe I'll cut my hair. Maybe. Or maybe it'll be good for the snow and the ice. I can put it around my face when the wind blows. And the shivers when the cold wind blows. In the pines, where the sun don't never shine. And you shiver when the cold wind blows. Yes, that's the song for the day. It's now going to be 6 minutes, but I'm not done yet. I really just wanted to say I went to the post office, and then I was going to argue with myself over whether I recite one of my poems to you or not, but I'm not going to. I'm just going to say thank you, life and creator, Father Heaven, Mother Earth, for giving us these lives we live here. In this world outside my window, I can see the bushes and the street and the hills. If I lean back, I can see through the trees. Ah, there's a big hill over there, one of our foothills. Now, these daydreams have revolved in my mind a long time, applying for the prize and having to leave the country. Where would I go? That's a huge daydream. I'm not going to go into it here because it's so long-winded. But needless to say, if I win, it will completely change my life. Instead of sitting around and cleaning house, I'll be wandering the world. That's just a daydream in a few words, even though I said I wouldn't talk about it a minute ago. But the other daydream, which is coming true next month, is to go see my son in New York City. Yep. And God willing, and the creek don't rise, as the saying goes. Should I be alive, I will go. Should I be alive and healthy? Should I be alive and kicking? Not just comatose attached to a breathing machine. Don't you ever attach me to a resuscitation machine. Don't you ever feed me with a tube. No, 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 no. You let me go. So, whoever you are, doctor, I went to the post office and mailed the prize-winning manuscript for $59,000 to travel around the world. I hate flying. But except for a boat, there's no other way across the water. So, maybe a UFO would like to take me off the continent. That the moon would be off the continent, wouldn't it? Yes. Anywhere, as long as it's not North America. So I've thought of going to Hawaii. That's really the closest place to San Diego. Off the continent. You can't go to Mexico. That's still North American continent. All the way down to Panama, I think. I should have checked the rules. Is Panama in North America? Is Costa Rica? Is anywhere in Central America in North America? Well, I'm pretty sure Mexico is because, you know, hell, the border's right here in North America. Now, it's true, we're in the southern half of North America because America was colonized by many Europeans, maybe some Chinese and Polynesians thousands of years before. And these Europeans in the 1600s gave us the three big languages. And if you count South America, the four big languages from Europe. English, the one I'm speaking right now. Español, el idioma que estoy hablando ahorita. Français, je parle français, oui, un peu. Portugués. Eu não falo português. I don't speak Portuguese. I can sort of understand it. And I speak a little French, but I understand less of it because it's less like Spanish, which I do speak and understand, and English. So these four languages, 10 minutes and 15 seconds, these four languages conquered North America and South America. Many other languages came. Hebrew, Yiddish, German, Dutch. In New York, you know, the Dutch were there first. It was New Holland, New Netherland, Manhattan, New Netherland. And then it was conquered by a British general, the Duke of York, and it became New York. So that's your quick history lesson at 10 minutes and 53 seconds. I'm over budget now. I wanted to have a 10-minute vlog, and it's going too long. Now, see, there I am. I'm scripting. I just can't help but script. The one thing I don't do for a video log anymore is very much editing at all. Sometime a little love bites, as one of my student friends from 40 years ago called it. Back in film school at the University of California, we were not allowed. We were making a sketchbook. The class was called sketchbook. We couldn't make cuts or edits, except for the final project that we could edit and cut, etc. But we weren't supposed to cut the weekly project. Every week we had another project. Quarters are short, only 10 weeks long. So as I apply for this scholarship, and as I stood in the front room a few days ago reading the poems to myself to see if they really were good enough for me to spend money, $1.60, oh no, it's wrong, $6.70 I spent on postage, but it's guaranteed to get there, and I have a tracking number. But it doesn't matter. If it doesn't get there, I won't be entered, because the rules say not postmark. Not postmark date. My mouth is dry. Not postmark date, but the date received. It must be received by the lawyers for the estate of the old lady poet from the 20th century, Amy Lowell. And it's in her memory that this, in her will, she put it, that these, I have bags under my eyes. I'm trying to make them go away by going like this. What did he need is light, Daniel. You need light. Look, he's got Halloween eyes. They're all dark and sunken. Ooh, Halloween eyes. Anyway, it'll be Halloween in another 3 weeks. And soon we will be celebrating November. All Souls Day, All Saints Day. And that, my friends, is called Day of the Dead. Now, I'm very Anglo-Saxon, so I never learned to make altars with the family pictures and fruits and cigarettes and drinks and food and all those wonderful things that are offered to the dead. The dearly beloved, dearly departed ancestors. And I probably won't make an altar to my mother because I'm not Mexican. I'm Anglo-Saxon. And I made an altar once in my hotel room in Mexico City when I went there on the Day of the Dead. That was 1990. And 14 minutes and 15 seconds. I had gone to Mexico City, which is where I really would like to travel, but it's not off the continent, you see. Hawaii is the closest place to San Diego off the continent. Down just beyond Panama is a few more hundred miles to Ecuador, Colombia, there in the corner of Panama. Used to be part of Colombia, you know, but it was cut off to make the canal. another long and involved political story. The United States talked with some local people in Panama, and they said, sure, give us your money. We'll declare ourselves independent as long as you shoot the Colombians when they come to take back Panama. Well, they did. And he had a gunboat there, and so gunboat diplomacy. Speak softly, but carry a big stick. Speak hardly, but carry a soft stick. I liked spoonerisms turning language around. I'm going to go on the train next month, and in the spring, I will have an answer from the Amy Lowell daydream. There's a nonstop flight. Now, if I have to fly, please let it be nonstop. Whether I go from LA, where you can fly a lot of places, many different places off the continent, in Europe and in Asia and in South America, you can fly from LA nonstop. But I'd rather fly from home. And there is one flight a day, nonstop, from San Diego to London. There is also one flight a day from San Diego to Tokyo. Now, from California to Tokyo is about 8 hours of time on the clock. And from California to London is about 8 hours of time on the clock. And from London to Tokyo is about 8 hours back around the other side of the earth on the clock. But each of those three great cities, of course, I think San Diego's great because it's home, but let us say we'll say Los Angeles, since that is a great city. If you like oranges. The cherry blossom, the Big Apple, oh, not the Big Apple, not New York, London. London is 5 hours from New York, but it's 8 hours from San Diego. So that's a perfect third of the clock. But each of these three great cities that I could fly to nonstop are in the Northern Hemisphere. And since I am here in San Diego at 33 degrees north latitude, if I really want to go around the world, at some point in time, I have to go south below the equator. Where is it? Down here where the hand is going. Yes. Below the equator. Back up around. And it just so happens by a weird fluke of fate that if you draw a line from San Diego to Tokyo, you could almost continue on to Hong Kong, and then a very long stretch across the Indian Ocean to Johannesburg in the Southern Hemisphere, and back over to South America, and up the west coast of South America and North America, because, you know, North America tilts to the west all the way up, and it makes a perfect circle. Now, I know this is true because I saw it on Google Earth. So what I really have to do is take the globe that's in this huge stand. Maybe I'll make a video of making a trip around the Earth on the globe next to the piano. Yes, that would be a good thing to do. Seeing as how we're almost 20 minutes now, and I don't want to spend much more time talking than that. Now, next time we speak, my friends, perhaps I will be seated at the piano with the globe to daydream of the great circle around the earth, from San Diego to Tokyo, and then down south slanting past Hong Kong, across the Indian Ocean to Johannesburg, South Africa, South America, and back up the West Coast to home. So that is time for me to say goodbye.